The United Nations says global human rights are in such a precarious state that they've gone into reverse in some cases. And the Universal Declaration of Human Rights is under siege. Our world leaders are gathered in Geneva to take part in the United Nations Human Rights Council session. That's where issues ranging from Russia's alleged war crimes in Ukraine to China's treatment of its Muslim minority will be under scrutiny. The UN High Commissioner is pushing for a new approach.
We need to forge a new worldwide consensus on human rights, broadening its base of support and moving forward together in recognition that our survival depends on finding our way back to that common language. Our goal must be to promote and implement a 21st century human rights vision that is transformative, solution-oriented, unifying, and that speaks directly to every person's need for justice and search for meaning in life.
UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres has labeled Russia's war on Ukraine as a massive violation of rights. Many states are likely to seek to extend the mandate of a UN investigation body that was set up to probe atrocities in the country.
The Office of the High Commissioner for Human Rights has documented dozens of cases of conflict-related sexual violence against men, women and girls, and serious violations of international humanitarian and human rights law against prisoners of war, and hundreds of cases of enforced disappearances and arbitrary detention of civilians were also documented.
For more on this story, Will Densler joins us live. He's in Kyiv. Will, the United Nations Human Rights Council session, that started today. What issues have been raised so far? And what effect might these talks have with regards to these alleged human rights abuses that have occurred in Ukraine?
Well, as we heard there from the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, some very strong words indeed. He said that Russia's invasion of Ukraine just over a year ago triggered the most massive human rights violation seen in the world today. He said it sparked death, destruction and displacement. Of course, this comes just a few months after an independent body that was appointed by the United Nations came to the conclusion that war crimes had been committed in Ukraine. Their focus was primarily on the area near Kyiv towards the start of the invasion back last spring. Now, when it comes to the overall outcomes, there is a real concern as the United Nations Human Rights body marks 75 years since the Universal Declaration on Human Rights was adopted, that it is not fully being adhered to or respected in some parts of the world. The message from the UN Secretary General is that it must, going forward, be implemented and fully respected by all.
Meantime, Will, there have been air defences in operation overnight in Ukraine as well. What more can you tell us about that?
Yeah, that's absolutely right. For over 5 hours, the air alarms were ringing out here in the capital, Kyiv. We understand that 9 drones were shot down in the Kyiv region across Ukraine. 11 out of 14 are believed to have shot down. We've also heard from the Interior Ministry here in the country. They say that 2 rescuers have been killed after drones hit the same site twice in a row while they were working on the ground overnight. We also know, according to Ukrainian officials, that they have repelled, as they say, 81 attacks from Russia over the past 24 hours. And we've had a little bit of an update from Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky when it comes to yet more shakeups in his top brass. He's made the announcement that the commander of the joint forces has been relieved of his duty. The president didn't give any explanation for that. But of course, this comes as there's been plenty of shakeups in Ukraine as the country's sought to clamp down on corruption. Of course, no indication as of yet whether the two things are related.
Will, thank you for that update. Will Denslow there for us live in Kyiv.